Hey guys, so in this video, it would be all about acne. So acne is this number one problem that we all have at some period of our lifespan. And in this video, I will talk about some of the acne facts. How can you prevent that? How can you reduce acne? How can you prevent acne? And how can you maintain your normal skin and normal healthy skin? So stay tuned to check it out. And also, if you're feeling extra awesome, guys, do hit on that like button and share this video if any of your friends or anyone like suffering from acne and wants to find a solution. And I hope I covered everything in this video, and if I miss out anything, I will surely do a second part of it. And if you are new to my channel, guys, subscribe and hit on that bell icon if you are want to get notified every time I upload. And so this would be my acne 101. Acne is a chronic inflammatory skin condition that causes spots and pimples, and especially on the face, shoulders, neck, décolleté, and any area possible. Basically, acne is a category in itself, and acne has many different vast majority of categories. So I'll talk about that also. So first of all, let us see. So what causes acne? So causes of acne can be vary from person to person. It can be hormonal. It can be on your genetics, and it can also depend upon the stress levels, your diet. So one of the basic main reason is when your hair follicles get clogged by dead skin cells and oil from the skin. So that is the main condition which cultivates acne. So there are various types of acne, and the causes and the solution of them are very different. So the first one is whiteheads. Usually it remains under your skin and they are really small. You cannot notice it that much. So the next category is blackheads. So blackheads is basically when the whiteheads inside your skin come in contact with the outside air and it oxidizes. So that is the blackheads. So blackheads are visibly larger than the whiteheads, and you can remove it by various scrubbing and acid exfoliating and everything. Another type of acne is papules. So papules are basically small, same to the whiteheads, and they are usually pink in color and they are visible on the surface of the skin. So they can be really related to rashes and everything. So the next kind of acne is pustules. So it is clearly visible, the normal kind of acne you get, which has pus around, the disgusting white pus around inside it. So that is the pustules. They are red at the base, so they are painful, and the blackheads and whiteheads, of course. And then comes the nobules. So nobules are clearly visible on the skin. They are large, solid, and when the pustules gradually becomes more bad, it forms into nobules. So nobules is basically when you have that hard you have the pus and you have to squeeze until you get that hard part outside, if you know what I'm telling. So that kind of a painful acne is known as nobules. So they are generally the last stage of the acne, and they are really painful. Last one is the cyst. Of course, cyst acne are very much visible. They depends upon various person to person. They can be very large, very small, depending again upon the person's skin. And it is very painful, filled with pus, filled with hard substances, everything bad. So cyst is the ultimate a bad state of the acne. So that was the various types of acne. So depending upon your skin and your acne type, the treatments can very much differ. So before coming to treatments, we can talk about the various different prevention techniques. So preventing acne is better than removing it, or the post acne thing. Prevention is very much better than treating. So that is why I wanted to mention some prevention steps. So my first prevention tip would be to not touch that acne. If you touch the acne, guys, it would gradually become more bad and it will leave a scar, because you won't be properly extracting the acne, and that leads to like broken blood capillaries, and that in turn leads to scars. So don't ever touch that acne. Next tip would be to use good quality acne fighting products. I know there are gazillion types of acne fighting products in the market, but finding the right product according to your skin type, and of course it had to be like made up of really good ingredients, and ingredients which will suit your skin and make your skin better, is very important. Also, following a skincare regime like CTM, the basic skincare regime, is very important, and following it up with day and night is really important, because when you take care of the skin like gives back to you. Like if you take a proper care of your skin, you won't ever have acne if possible. So following it up with a proper skincare regime is really important, guys. Another thing is using a mild product. So when you are having acne, your skin is really irritated, and you need to calm that acne, or you need to calm that skin, and by using mild products, it really doesn't irritate your skin that much, and you can also prevent that at the same time. And the last most important prevention of any skincare game is like using SPF. So when you're using when you're not using SPF, what it does, like, it harms your skin, it harms your upper layer of the skin, of course it forms scars and everything, but it also leads to form more sebum production. As you get outside, your skin is red, your skin is irritated, so acne just comes. So using SPF would solve 50% of your skin problems, I bet, guys. And using SPF every single day, 365 days, every day, guys. Don't like exclude that, oh, today is cloudy, there is not much of a sun, so I don't need to follow up with an SPF. That is completely wrong, guys. Use an SPF right now. So guys, following it up, coming to the prevention technique, that is following it up with a good CTM routine, you need to like focus upon, of course, the ingredients, second the how the product is, and the third the helpful ingredient that will benefit you from like getting acne. So coming to like cleanser, always use a mild cleanser and something that has salicylic acid in it. So salicylic acid is basically a type of BHA. BHAs are supposed to be very exfoliating agents, and that also like BHAs are very much known for their exfoliating properties, and they work outside of your skin, so it exfoliates really nicely, gets rid of all of the oil and dead skin cells, and in turns give you a very nice clean skin, and which harbors less of the bacteria and also less acne. So using salicylic acid is very important, and also something that is not stripping. So what normally oily skin people, the first mistake they do is buying something that strips your skin completely, which is completely wrong. If you are stripping your skin, that tells your skin to produce more oils, and the production of more oil contribute to like production of more acne. So very important step would be to not use anything stripping on your skin. So coming to toner, so after cleansing, you need to follow up with the toner. So toner, so you need to find a toner that will calm your skin, that will cool down your skin. So lowering the temperature of your skin is really important, and that is like highly beneficial if you have acne. So toner, something like using a calming toner will really calm your skin, and also like give your skin a cool feeling. And it also something like, if you are like having very bad acne, acid exfoliating is really important. If you want me to do a whole video about explaining what acid exfoliating is, do let me know in the comment box below, because acid exfoliating is the best acne treatment ever. Like, I have gotten rid of every acne possible, and also the scars are 80% less visible now, because I started including acids in my skincare routine. So let me know, guys, if you want a whole video dedicated to acid exfoliating. Like, I have so much to talk about acid exfoliating and how important it is. So let me know. So coming to the toner, use a toner which has mandelic acid. So if you are using mandelic acid, so mandelic acid is basically a type of AHA. AHA is considered again a very important like acid exfoliator. So it not only like works on your epidermis layer, but also goes deep down and provides hydration and moisture. So mandelic acid is basically the very like calmest and soothest and very less irritant form of exfoliation. So using mandelic acid in a toner, what will do is, of course, it will get rid of the dead skin cells, and also it will let your other skincare products to absorb much faster and much more efficiently. So using mandelic acid in a toner is a really nice buy. So for cleanser, for cleanser, the product recommendation I would give is using something like this Kaya salicylic acid cleanser. It is really nice. It is a gel type cleanser, so it doesn't foam that much, but it's really nice. You can also use like the Spa Wake 2-in-1 foam cleanser. That is a really nice cleanser. And also you can use a baby body wash, which is like best for sensitive skin. And for toner, I would really recommend the only toner which has mandelic acid, which I came across, is the Kaya mandelic acid toner. It's really affordable. It comes in a spray bottle, but don't use that toner in a spray bottle. Take a cotton pad and then just wipe it up. So that works really best. So that toner is like the perfect acne solution you might get. And I don't know why in like where I live, or in India at least, there are not much skincare brands that focus upon acid exfoliating, but because in K-beauty, acid exfoliating has become a huge thing. So the Kaya is only Kaya is the only brand that I have seen like very beneficial, using very beneficial acid exfoliants such as mandelic acid and comedons things and everything. So Kaya one is a really nice toner. So after toner, you need something to like actually treat your skin. So using serums is the best way. So serums are basically to treat your skin. Like it has very much important key ingredients. You should always choose a serum according to your skin problems. So if you have acne, focus upon a comedon serum. So comedon is basically for the pore problem and everything. So if you like combat the whiteheads and blackheads with the comedon, then your acne game would be completely changed and you will develop less acne. So I will really recommend this comedon control serum by Kaya again. So this serum is really nice. The smell is a little bit funky, but if you like pass on that smell, the serum works wonders. You will develop less blackheads immediately after 7 days after continuous usage, because I have seen a difference and I really like it. And also very important thing is exfoliating your skin. Again, if you can't like use mandelic acid or anything like that, use exfoliator which is really less irritant to your skin. So using something as cheap as this Clean and Clear blackhead scrub is really nice. And also if you want to step up that acne game, do include acids in your skincare, guys. It's really life-changing. So the product recommendation is this Clean and Clear blackhead clearing scrub. And also if you want to invest a little bit, then the Innisfree wine peeling jelly softener is a really nice exfoliator. By the way, that is a chemical exfoliator, and Clean and Clear is a physical exfoliator, so you need to choose again. I have done a whole video upon how the chemical exfoliator and physical exfoliator differs, and I have that is exactly my nighttime skincare routine, the debut K-beauty night routine, so you can check this video right here. After that, the most important step is spot correcting. So spot correcting is basically after you have like post on that acne period, you have some spots, or even if you have like inflamed acne, you need to like calm that down. So using acne strips is really important. It doesn't like if you have that urge to pick that acne, just put on that acne patch and you would be less like provocative to touch that acne. So acne strips are really important. The only acne strip is available in India, like widely available, is the Dr. Belmour one by Face Shop. Also if you can buy the COSRX acne patches in beautybarn.com. they're really affordable for the quality. I think they are 400 rupees and they're really nice, guys. Do buy if you want to invest in a good acne patch. And also Dr. Belmour is one is also good one. That was for the acne part. And if you want to use something as a spot corrector, then this Kaya like spot correcting treatment is both good for your spots and also calming down that redness of your acne. So you can use that. And the last thing of every routine is using an SPF. So using an SPF always is really important. Not always, the daytime, at least in day always. So my product recommendation is this one. I'm sorry, guys. my product recommendation has to be this one, because affordable sunscreen doesn't work for me that much, and I really don't like their consistency. This is a high-end sunscreen. You can also check out the Neutrogena one, that is also good for an affordable sunscreen. But my recommendation is this one. If you are suffering from acne, guys, if you like break out with every sunscreen, at least for me, I break out with everything. Even the Neutrogena one, I had break out with at least one. But this one, no breakouts, and no breakouts certified by me, no breakout. This is the Face Shop Natural Sun SPF 40 PA Triple Plus Sun Cream. It has again both sunblock properties and sunscreen properties. It is a chemical exfoliant, it is a chemical sunscreen, and it doesn't leave any void cast. And the best factor about this is it's no sebum, and also it has a blurring effect, so I really like the sunscreen. Again, SPF is really important, guys. Choose any sunscreen, you need to apply sunscreen. Even if you are at home, choose a day cream which has SPF protection, so you can be protected always. So hey guys, that was my like acne or some facts about acne which I want to tell you guys. And if you want to like really cure your acne, you can start with this video and use the products that I told you. The very important, like if you want to start your acne game, I would really suggest the Kaya acne skincare kit. I have gone through all of them, so I don't have the kit currently. Cost about I think 1500 to 2000 rupees, but it has a cleanser, the salicylic cleanser that I mentioned, the mandelic acid toner, a nourishing moisturizer or something. That moisturizer is really good. It has, if I'm not wrong, it has salicylic acid too, and it also comes with the spot correcting treatment. So it's a really nice basic starter kit, and you can also invest on that Comedon serum. So that's a really nice if you want to like start your acne game, and I really recommend that kit specifically. So this was the beginner type of acne video. If you want a advanced version of this which will include like acid exfoliant and other preventions, so you can tell me in the comment box below, guys. And also if you are interested in the acid exfoliation, do let me know, guys. It's really beneficial. It will change your acne game, guys. Trust me when I say this. And like this video if you like the video, comment down below, share this video with your friends who are really suffering from acne, and subscribe to my channel, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. So bye bye. Can you be my la-la?